Five Investigates tonight is following the money when it comes to marijuana consumption. Our Mike Baudette discovered the money says a lot about changing habits here in Massachusetts. Take a look.
Hi, I'm here to pick up for last name Letters.
Olivia Letters is a regular.
Here's 140.
She shops at marijuana dispensaries in Massachusetts. Today, she's picking up a new flower to smoke.
Thanks so much. Have a great day. In my circle, I guess, I'm 30. People drink less alcohol and smoke more weed, at least in Massachusetts.
It seems like weed is now everywhere in Massachusetts. You can't drive very far without seeing the signs advertising for recreational marijuana. Since adult use retailers opened here in November 2018, gross total sales have now reached $2.54 billion.
We get younger adults, we get all the way up to our geriatric patients and everyone in between.
Michaela Bell is the community outreach manager for Netta, which operates three dispensaries in Massachusetts.
I think that people are looking for an alternative to make them feel better. You know, oftentimes people are turning to alcohol for relief, and now they found another product without the hangover, without the calories.
Bell says the general public is becoming more comfortable with the idea of recreational marijuana, even if they're not using it themselves. But the data obtained by Five Investigates reveals plenty of people are consuming it. Alcohol excise taxes in Massachusetts have been nudging upwards, hitting $51 million midway through this fiscal year. But recreational marijuana excise taxes have skyrocketed since legalization, passing alcohol to hit $74
million. Do those numbers surprise you?
You know, when I first heard that, I was a little shocked, but at the same time, it doesn't completely blow me away.
When a market transitions from medical to adult use, you can see a doubling or even a tripling of revenues almost overnight.
Vivian Azer is a senior Wall Street research analyst and managing director at Cowen, covering the emerging cannabis sector. She says the higher tax rates on marijuana compared to alcohol contribute to the rising tax revenues. The excise tax of 10.75% on recreational cannabis is only about half of the total tax revenue being collected. There's also a 6.25% state sales tax, plus a local tax of up to 3%. It all added up to nearly $210 million in tax revenue last fiscal year.
Not only is the industry growing by migrating current consumers out of the illicit market into the legal market, but you're also engaging consumers that have probably tried the product once in their lifetime, but then moved away from the category, but now have permission to re-engage with the category now that it's legal.
The legal, recreational, and medical marijuana market generated about $25 billion in sales across the country last year. Azer says the pandemic increased cannabis sales with people on lockdown and having more disposable income. But she says consumption trends have now started to normalize. Mike Baudette, Five Investigate.